Do you work in an industry where it's difficult to do user research because your product deals in private or sensitive information? Things like healthcare, finance, accounting, or law? It can be a real challenge to be able to access actual user accounts or even record sessions where personal information gets shown on the screen. Here are a few tips to make this easier. Consider creating realistic but fictionalized data. Sometimes it's possible to take real data and have it modified to change names, addresses, social security numbers, and financial information to something fake but realistic enough for users to complete tasks. Resist the temptation to make it funny, though. Don't use Game of Thrones character names or other stuff like that. If you're running an e-commerce study, consider providing a company credit card number instead of asking participants to use their own. I'll often compensate e-commerce study participants by paying for goods they purchased during the session, up to a certain limit, instead of giving them money. Now, if real data is a must, make test participants aware that you will be using their real data way before the study, in the beginning of the recruiting process. Make clear the purpose of the session, the type of information you'll be asking them to use during the session, such as their credit card information or a login to an account. Tell them what steps you'll take to protect their privacy, such as blurring out details in video recordings, and let them know how long you'll store the recordings and where. Make sure that this information is again included in your informed consent form, and make sure that users are actually clear on the details before the session begins. At the end of the session, clear out the browser cache and cookies in front of the user and explain what you're doing and why. And then follow through with your data retention policies. Edit out the personally identifying information as soon as you can after the session. Sometimes, though, recording a session just won't be possible due to the amount of personal information that gets shown on the screen. If this happens, don't panic. The most important thing is to train your team to take good notes. Ideally, we'll have a good cross-functional team observing the session. It's not just UX people. They'll need some help with their analysis and their note-taking. What I do is I run a pilot session with just one user to help train my team to take good notes. I'll do a remote test and have my team all take their notes in a shared Google spreadsheet. After 15 minutes in the session, I'll pause it, read over my team's notes, and give them some discrete feedback about their note-taking via chat so that the participant doesn't hear what I'm saying, and then go back to the session with my participant. Quotes are especially tough to get verbatim, so make sure everybody is responsible for capturing good quotes. When you go back to the notes, you can reconstruct what the participant said from several different transcriptions, even if no one note-taker got the whole thing exactly right. Redacted screenshots are better than no recorded information at all. So see if it's possible to have the participant take screenshots during the session, and then have someone redact them of private information for you to use in your analysis later. Being trustworthy and transparent is incredibly important, and your participants will be able to tell if you're being an honest and careful steward of their private information.